I have heard a lot of bad takes about this subject. The Toronto Maple Leafs were just fined $100,000 for traveling on Boxing Day. Why is this a fine? Well, the collective bargaining agreement between the NHLPA and the league, or the CBA, specifically says that December 24th, Christmas Day, and December 26th shall be off days for all purposes, including travel, and no club may request a player's consent to practice on such days for any reason. I saw a lot of bad takes about this, especially from someone I like, Steve Dangle. No hate on the guy. But he tweeted, "Attaboy Gary, you're a hero, buddy." And later, 90 minutes early and the players agreed. If the players were against it, I'd be against it. But it sounds like a common sense solution was agreed upon and then punished. That's dumb. Now, this I don't agree with. If you study labor law or labor relations, industrial relations, whatever, you'll learn that the collective bargaining agreement exists to protect the rights of the players. NHL players do not get very many days off. The CBA is strongly worded, so their days during the holiday are protected. In situations like this, you should not be able to consensually release yourself from the rights that your players' association has bargained for, because that severely diminishes the effectiveness of them even existing. Imagine this. Which player is going to say, if asked and pressured, "No, my Christmas is more important than the team's success"? And imagine for a second you're not John Tavares or Austin Matthews, but the 12th forward. Are you going to be the guy that says, "No, I want to spend time with my family," especially when you know that your job is in the hands of the coach? Collective bargaining is designed so that individuals don't have to make these high pressure decisions and that their rights are protected on a systemic level. Hockey is a highly competitive environment, and for the well-being of the players, the time they get off needs to be protected. Now, I understand in this situation, the players and the team may have felt like they were doing what was best and what was most convenient, and maybe that's true to an extent, but the rights still need to be protected. I believe there were 15 NHL games on the 27th. That's 14 teams that managed travel, whatever distance, without having to resort to breaking the CBA. My suggestion? Bump back the day the games actually start. Have the 27th be designated as a travel day. Let the NHL partner with the IIHF to focus on the wonderful World Juniors, which are being played at that time of year, showcasing young, up-and-coming, and some even current NHL players, then make the 28th a big day back. That would be my idea, and I think that would be what's best for the players. But let me know what you think down below.